afternoon. Welcome again to our class. By now, I guess everyone should be registered on Open Learning already. It's called Lean Technopreneurship. So, I hope everyone has come up with their own group. It's either a team of two or you can work individually as well. It's totally up to you. Remember the other day we had an assignment that is due. So, what are the three factors that, the main three factors that we talk about in the Lean Startup lecture by Cal? Remember the other day, we actually have like customer, right? So what else for the assignment that you need to fill up? Do you remember? You need to identify who are your customers, and then the P, right? The challenges. And the last one, when you come up with the challenges, you would also come up with assumptions, or what we call as core assumptions, right? Or we can call it as hypothesis as well. So I hope by now everyone should have had a clear idea of what project they want to work on based on whatever that we have submitted last Friday, right? Have you done that, Kenji? You should do that soon, alright? So but after streaming through some of your answers, I realized that some of us still kind of get a little bit confused with the core assumptions. So, what are core assumptions basically? Remember the other day when Cal came over and spoke to us, and then like we did an exercise to talk about getting a valet parking, right? So, what are the core assumptions? So, let's try to just work it out like a little bit based on the valet parking example, right? Because I noticed that some of you have submitted your assignment, but the core assumptions do not really match to what it's supposed to mean, because core assumptions are those factors or those stuff that you would want to test on later on. Remember, because Lean Startup is all about building everything quickly, as basic as possible, and then you want to run it through a test to see whether your customer actually likes it or not. If yes, then you go ahead. If no, then you actually do a repetition of it, right? So if we are talking about providing valet parking service in Taylors, who are your customers? Taylor students, but do all Taylor students need valet parking? We have to be more specific than that. So, what about? And they also need to drive to campus, right? Right? So that's how we actually scope the customer. So, the customer would be Taylor students who drive to campus. Like you said, probably that would fall under the core assumption. Right? So what are the challenges or the P statement here? So what do they face? Why the need? So these are the needs for why they need valet parking service and all that, all right? Because when we come up with something or when we come up with a project, we want to be able to solve the challenges or the issues they are facing. So what are the challenges that they have here that require valet parking service?
Trust
issue. But why the need for valet parking service? So that's what it meant. They're in a rush. So lack of parking, that could be one of it. What else? Like you said just now, that's like a core assumption. Right? So what else? lack of parking space, and then probably you wanna like gauge you wanna point out the distance from the parking to the campus, therefore. So that is therefore the solution to it. So this could be the challenges for getting a valet parking service. Now we come to core assumptions. Alright? So we definitely need to like set out a few baseline or hypotheses to test out, right? So when we actually suggest valet parking service, what are the core assumptions? Just now Kenji said something about the students will need this during the off-peak hour, because like during the peak hour everyone would have got their parking space. So during the off-peak then probably there's no parking space already left. Alright? So what else? What else can we establish for the core assumption? Trust issue
with the car.
Yeah. So you're saying about a trust issue. The students might have some trust issue with handling over the car. All right. So that's one of the core assumption. What else? So remember, core assumption. My point being. A core assumption has to be constructed or crafted in such way that you will be able to test it out later on. Because now we are like sort of like at the second phase of our project already. Because the other day we already thought about what you want to do for your project, for the crowdfunding, right? And then, therefore, remember the other day we did not have class, but we actually made it, made an assignment due that you're supposed to submit. And these are part of the stuff that you need to write and submit. All right. So today we'll just talk a little bit about, for the core core assumption also, we have by now identified which one is the riskiest one, right? Because the riskiest one is the one that you want to be testing out on, right? And then the other day we have three types of testing, right? So you want to know which one you plan to use that for the testing of your project. And you are supposed to be discussing with your teammate today about how you plan to execute the testing part. All right? Because like the other day, you have constructed the idea, you have known what project you want to do. So now you're like trying to getting the idea started already, right? You came up with the core assumptions and stuff. So now it's time for you to really think through about how you're going to test it. All right? So you want to be going around to the customer, or you can be providing a service or a product. So you want to go to the targeted customer that you have identified earlier and really test it out. Because remember, we have this loop of build, measure, learn. So from today onwards, you will be discussing with your friends to see how you want to test it out and where you're going to go, probably just all the details that you need to find out who are your customers, or if it really reflects to what you have written down earlier, all right? But besides that, I would like to just talk a little bit also about innovation accounting. So, you know, like sometimes when we go through this testing the product and to see whether the customer like it or not, right? Sometimes we might succeed. When we succeed, then we can just go all along, aligning ourselves with whatever project that we came up with. But sometimes there needs to be a time when you sort of fail, but that's a good failure, right? Because you actually learn something from it. But when you fail, how do you know whether you actually fail because you learn or just fail because you're totally misguided? All right? So there's this part in Lean Startup Principle that actually talks about it, and it's actually called innovation accounting. Alright, so innovation accounting is basically turning whatever your core assumptions, right, to test out and then to turn it into a qualitative financial method, so to speak. So it's actually for you to know whether it's, there are three steps to it, basically. So first of all, for innovation accounting, first of all, you want to build your MVP, right? Does everyone know already by now what MVP is? Minimum viable product. So let's say you have a product, you know, like when we talk about it, like sometimes more often than not, all these conventional, traditional company, they will just come up with a product and then will be finalized and take so much of time into completing the finalized polished product before they put it up on the market, right? And sometimes it fails, sometimes it succeeds. But should it fail, then you actually already spend too much of time and all that. So what a minimum viable product is basically like you have your product with just its essential features, the important ones. It can still be in its rough state, nothing too polished or whatever. And then you test it out. Because when you test it out also, you will know whether your customers like it, or even if the customers actually complain or whatever, from there you actually know what features are missing or what they actually need. So from there you can decide to whether either to pivot a little bit, make some change and all that, right? So the first part, the most important part, is to do that. So that's where your core assumptions come in. And that's why I stress a little bit on that today, because based on the core assumptions that you have laid out in your project, you're supposed to test them out to the customers, all right? So second of all, you want to be identifying your, what do we call that? You want to tune the engine. So that's what they call. Tuning the engine basically comprises identifying your key drivers or the growth or the factors that will actually draw your product to be different from anyone else's one, all right? So for example, you wanna do some valet parking service. So what makes your project stand out more? What makes it different from the other? So we need to have like these several factors, all right? So those factors are supposed to be the ones that will drive your project to be somewhat different and much better than others, all right? So the thing that we actually always have to ask ourselves when we come up with a project is that, will your customer love it, all right? Is your product good enough? How is your product different? What's so great about your product or your service or your project compared to everyone else's one? Because right now, you might have one project, but it also can be similar to other people's one, right? So that's the thing. And the third one would be the part where you pivot or you persevere. So that's why it's very important for us to run the test based on your core assumptions. So please be reminded that your core assumptions must be something that we can test out on the customers. Because by next week, as you can see in videos and activities on Open Learning, there's another activity included already. It's called your project selection, if I'm not mistaken. Remember the other day we submitted Lean Startup tutorial, right? So just at the bottom, we actually have your project already. When you click on that, it actually lists down a few stuffs there. So take those as your guidelines to discuss for this week, because you will need to really like start working on your idea, test it out on the customer and all. And then by next week, you will need to do a short presentation about what are your findings. What have you found out after running the tests with the customers? All right? Because now we are in week 4. Week 6 is the time when we actually put up our crowdfunding campaign, right? Live. So it will be somewhere week 6 to week 4, week 13, week 12, week 13, right? So by now we should really start running the test already. So I want you all to get into your group, your team, to really discuss about how you do the test, and then use the link that is on Open Learning, your project selection. We have like a list of stuff that you can take as guideline. All right, and that link of the activity would be due next week as well. All right, so today is about you discussing it with your teammate, how you're gonna test your core assumptions. Let's see, and then at the first part, it will be describing your project. Let's see if you have sort of tuned your project into something else that is slightly different from whatever that you have submitted earlier on in the first assignment. All right, if it stays the same, it stays on course, then just describe it briefly. And then you will also need to start looking and researching on the crowdfunding campaign, all right? Someone asked just now about crowdfunding campaign, and I think, let me just tell you a little bit about crowdfunding campaign. You are free to choose whatever platform you want, all right? Mostly based on previous semesters, some actually choose Pidgin, some actually choose Possible. So what you can do is that you really look at how your project falls into what kind of category, and then you can look at the successful campaign that are posted online, and you can try to extract what actually makes them work, all right? What makes them successful and all that, and what are the key points that you can try to use and emulate in your project for your crowdfunding also. Because by now, you need to start thinking about whether your customers will want it or not. By next week, you will know about whether you want to stay on track going on with whatever project that you have come up with, or you might want to pivot it to something else. Because after you run through the test with the customers, you will find out that sometimes it's not as what it is. Sometimes your customer could be like some other different type of customers altogether, or sometimes you might find out that like, oh, whatever that you're offering actually is missing out certain features. So those are the part when you can actually tweak and work on before we actually put up the crowdfunding platform. So remember, crowdfunding should be up by week 6. So next week, week 5, you'll make a short presentation of whatever that you have found out or discussed for today, and we will base on project selection link as the guideline. Is everyone clear about what you have to do? So make sure that the core assumptions in your project are those that you can test out to the customer, because you are supposed to be running the test, right? So yeah, so you need to be able to already have found, by then you should be able to know already whether your idea works or whether it actually needs a little bit of tweaking and all that. Because like by then, that would be week 5. Week 6 would be the time that you put up the crowdfunding campaign already. So next week will be more on like the feedback of what you can do, and then we can do some discussions about it. So discuss this week. We will give you some time, and then Yvonne and I will be going around like table to table to help you out with it, and we can discuss and share ideas. Then next week will be the presentation on it. Is everyone clear about what to do? Yeah? So get into your groups, start discussing, make any necessary changes to your core assumptions if needed to, because based on the previous submissions, some people are not really clear about what core assumptions are. So, all right, get to work. All right, we will see what you have in mind and all. Yes? Sorry?
How is core assumptions different from
the... Because after you have identified the challenge, you know the customer, then you have identified the challenge. So there are certain baseline that you put as benchmark or whatever. Because like you need a certain like benchmark before you, when you come up with your idea, right? So like for example, like your valet parking. So your assumptions are, one of them, it could be like, okay, the students actually do not mind paying up to, let's say, 15 to 20 bucks for valet parking service. So there are a general few guidelines that you just sort of like think about and brainstorm and come up with. And then you pick which one is the riskiest one. Like for example, just now you mentioned that, oh, okay, students might have trust issue with handling over the car to someone stranger to them, right? So those can be, core assumptions can be of anything. Whatever that you feel like, okay, based on this, what can I assume? What is my general hypothesis? That's why hypothesis is meant to be tested, which is what you're supposed to be doing. Today you're discussing it, then later on you will have to like go around and all that to really find out whether people actually like your idea or not. Because no matter how good your idea is, if it doesn't attract customers, then most likely you will be having a crowdfunding platform who's by the end of the day just secured zero ringgit or whatever. Right? So we try to not make that happen. We want to make a successful one. What's your project again, by the way? Okay. No, it's okay. I mean, like, okay. Oh, easy one.
Yeah.
So you guys just it based on easy.
Yes.
Okay, tell me your idea.
It is to encourage people, to tell people how is it to become a vegetarian in Kuala Lumpur.
Tell people how to become a vegetarian in Kuala Lumpur. You might want
what
to.
What challenges to become a vegetarian?
But you know that the challenges that we have here are like those challenges that they faced, right? The customer face and all that, right? All right.
So
how is this aligned?
So, we are trying to help.
Because we are eliminating the P word, right? So we replace it with.
To help people who wants to be.
Are you vegetarian?
I'm one of those who wants to be vegetarian but can't.
Because.
Yeah, that's why this project here. Yeah.
What about you?
I'm supporting you.
You're supporting him, but are you vegetarian?
When we do this, then I'm going to be a vegetarian.
Really?
Right.
Are you sure?
So that's how you're gonna
like full-time this. Vegetarian, that's not easy fit, you know?
So
do you live with your family in the first place?
Sorry?
Do you live with your family?
Yeah, I live with family.
But your family is not vegetarian by any chance, right?
I can just eat a veggie.
Really? Okay, so okay. But how is this addressing our GC?
So I already posted a few posts.
Mm-hmm.
Means you don't eat meat. So if you don't do to feed the cows and
animals,
you need a lot of crops.
Yeah.
So you need much more water and you save much you indirectly save a lot of carbon dioxide in your case.
So which one of the 14 grand challenges will you come
with? More than one.
But the choose the one that is
the right one is the carbon decision.
So you as long as you manage to really like put it aligned with the scope and all that. So what are the challenges that they face?
Challenges are eager to find out the facts to go out and execute.
So you are targeting those that want to be vegetarian but they are not. Or those that are already vegetarian.
I'm sure that a lot of us have some clue about becoming a vegetarian, but then they might not know how, or their environment, like their friends don't agree. And so we're gonna share the challenges that are happening in Malaysia.
So who are your customers first? Those that want. You wanna come up with something of how to solve how to become a vegetarian.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. Alright. So who are your customers? Right. We need to get
everyone,
the three
base. Everyone that are not ready.
Yeah, that's so, the key point.
That's why we are doing this campaign to encourage them to be vegetarian.
But as in like, I think, of course you're targeting those who are not vegetarian, but I think that's too general, because there would be like some people that, I want meat, I cannot not have meat for one day. And then we have like those that are like, oh, maybe I don't mind being a vegetarian, but I don't know how to. So you have to scope it down somewhere.
Maybe a meal out of the 3 meals, like one meal would be meat.
So you want to drive some sort of a campaign for that?
Yeah.
Any comment based on whatever that you saw or what they tweeted? Anything that you want?
So what we are pledging now, we are thinking of for every dollar that we pledge for our company, we ourselves will eat the capital and eat this meal, and then we will proceed to the actual power.
Will you be up for it?
Yeah, I'm challenging you as well.
All for healthy living.
And we will challenge them.
So what are your core assumptions? You want to really refine the scope of your customers, because you can't just simply say non-vegetarian, right? So you need to really think it through again. And then the challenges, what are the challenges? Have they mentioned? Probably how to go about with being a vegetarian, how to get the food. Think about it, then your core assumptions. So those are the things that you want to test out later and go around to your friends or whatever to ask them whether they are up for it. So you want to be testing out your core assumption. So name me one of your core assumptions, or it's something that you want to think about some more. Have you thought about it? The core assumptions or the hypothesis that you have for your project? It's okay. It's okay to find out now. It's individual, right? That one? So, no worry. But you guys are clear now, right? About what to do. Then now you want to discuss and then look at project selection also. You want to look at the crowdfunding campaign and then you want to test out your core assumptions. And then remember we talked about what types of method is it for
to test
your core assumptions.
Yeah.
Yeah. We have exploration, we have pitch, and then we have concierge, right? So you want to think about how you're going to go about with asking people, how do you know your project is going to work or not? Think about it that way. Right? What type of test you're running? Are you doing a survey? Are you doing an interview or what? And what type, then you have to start crafting your question. You can do anything and all that, but we definitely need data by next week. You want to know whether, like, is it just the two of you who are into vegetarian? Or could it be like, there's like a good 20-30% of our community here that will support that? Most probably you'll get the support from the vegetarian themselves, but you want to make sure that this thing actually will work. In Taylor's, I guess, you're running it like in...
Just ask your name.
So Taylor students wouldn't mind being vegetarian for me. One of the core assumptions.
Yeah, like, as in like...
And then
for
you
example.
Have to test out, like, set a minimum number of students that say yes, then the core assumption is validated. Something like
yeah.
That.
So it's like out of the, let's say, like 50 people that you ask or whatever, how many people or how many percent of these 50 people that actually say yes will actually pass your benchmark of the core assumption? So that's very important. How do you know whether this is workable? Is it one person that says yes, or 3 or 4 or 15? So all this you need to set it, alright? Think about it. But I think the vegetarian idea is somewhat new. Yeah, I know it's not new. No, it's fine, it's fine. Yeah, I think you can. Or either that, you know, that's why I actually put another part there, like describe your project and all. What you can do is you just mention that you have changed it. Are you working alone? Uh-huh. Yeah, it's cool. As long as the maximum number of people that you should have in classes. Yeah. Yeah, yeah, so it's fine. You can get as many people as you want. If you want to. There's no obligation to. But not within, yeah, not within the class. You can always like get someone to. You just need to make sure that whatever idea that you have is doable within our time frame as well. The one that you want to make sure that that's why in one of the questions we actually ask if the time frame actually fits. Whether you can work on a you want to think of a project that is like scalable towards being able to be done within the semester. And when you talk about health informatics, it's interesting, but lately I have actually also heard, because health is one part of it, informatics is another part of it, right? So it actually involves technology and stuff like that. So it actually really depends on what project or idea that you have.
It's basically like digitalizing, like exactly like smart care, but it implies.
But do you have to like come up with your own software and So what's the rough idea that you have? It's okay even if it's available, but if do you think that it's something that you can improve some more? Because like nowadays, really, like all the ideas are not exactly very original, right? It's always somewhat the same thing, but you have to really think about what makes your project stand out more than, or what makes it different from the other projects and stuff. Oh, you're in EE? Same, we're of the same background. But yeah, I agree with you. So it doesn't have to, because if you're talking about developing like a software or something like that, then I think it's going to take more than one semester. Then it's not going to be visible, right? Yeah, you can work on something, but make sure that like that something of whatever idea that you have is something that you can execute after the crowdfunding campaign finishes. Because when you succeed and all that, then you are sort of like you will be committed to complete the project, right? Within the probably the next 6 months or to a year or whatever. But you want to think about something that is not too difficult for you to be able to complete, you know? Yeah, that's quite diverse and quite huge, right? For something that you can really work on and all. Oh, I was one also last time. I really love. Yeah. Are you still doing one right now?
Yeah.
Oh, that's good. Then there's definitely something or room for improvement that you can actually do regarding that. Yeah. But see to that, they're like, you know, like, as of like this week and all that, by the end of the weekend and all, you should have things that you are clear of already, and then you want to quickly like test out your idea. Yeah, and then you will have found out already what are the discoveries or the results from whatever that you tested out on. You're like torn between two projects. Probably you want to discuss it with your friends or with your boyfriend and see which one they feel more strongly about, which one you're more passionate about. But I see you're talking about your eyes practically just like sort of bright up when you talk about advanced personalized learning. But that's just what I heard. Yeah. So you know more about it. Oh. Women should be right. Listen to them. Not to be sexist, sorry. It's just like, oh, women. I know sometimes when you have like too many ideas, then it's a bit like hard to... Also, he's like in medicine and... I leave it to y'all, whatever. Be as creative as you want to be. So who are your customers?
Customers, household, people, probably villages outside of KL.
Like the outskirts area.
Yeah, and also city folk. Because we have like that river going through KL itself, we could actually utilize all that energy.
Alright, core assumptions.
Core assumptions would be clean energy, reduce electric bill, reduce coal and natural gas usage. And we're still coming up with a few more.
Alright, then you want to make sure that those are the metrics that you can test on. Right? Have you thought about how you're going to test it? Because this session is all about discussing about how you're going to test it. Because like by next Friday, you will have come up with results already. To see whether it's doable or you need to keep it or whatever.
That's the thing, we're trying to come up with an experiment which we can use to test all of it.
So, get the brain just flowing, alright? Yes!
Hey, come on lah! Vertical first, okay?
Vertical first?
Yeah, go on, next one.
I know
please.
You're working alone, right?
Yeah, I'm working alone.
You're working alone too?
Who's working?
Behind.
Behind.
I have an idea, I just talked to Yvonne. I want to come up with a planner that works on your goals, like yearly, monthly, and weekly. And then after that, having your meeting slides right after your daily, because I have like a few meetings in a day. But then the next thing I want to incorporate is different than any other planners is a minimal design. And second, like a buzzer LED timer. So for example, like you set the timer in half an hour, and like the next half an hour, you know that you have a meeting. Because the problem with carrying this kind of planner is that I constantly have to open it to remind myself when's the next meeting. But I don't want to put it in my phone because I don't like having it on my keying everything on my phone.
I know. I'm a book
person. Yeah, I'm a book person as well. And I think it's not so much in the Malaysian market that I will have to appear. I will go out for like on Kickstarter or something like that because I think US has a better market for planners.
It's totally up to you, like,
so, but I think the next problem is to come up with the circuit thing because I'm not from an EE background, so I have to work on that. But I do book binding, so I know how it can be incorporated on your the cover of the book. So I would have to come up with the prototype at least, so then I would have a legit one to work on. Yeah. Yeah, so that I can get a nice video of it.
Yeah, that would be good. And I think because you want to just get like a simple buzzer type or something, right?
Shouldn't be a problem. Yeah, I'm like actually using it right now.
That was your
so
idea.
I'll work, yeah, it's actually his idea, but I work on
Shareholder.
Shareholder! 20%.
Yes.
Yeah, so I probably like make it different on how the buzzer should come out or how the buzzer, the lighting. Yeah, it can be different color or different whatever style. Picture. Yeah, I'll have to figure that out. But I have to come up with a prototype as soon as I can.
Yep. Well, see what you've done for the previous project. That should have been easier. And probably another one that you have to think about is customer needs.
Not
and
here.
How you're gonna like test.
Probably get like go to more corporate because I'm pretty sure. Because all these planners are always sell in very high-end bookstores, yeah, and these high-end bookstores only have like these corporate people going to. So I guess my target market will have to go around there and try like my aunties who works in corporate and see whether they like the idea of having a reminder like every half an hour.
If you can come up with something or whatever,
then the results of it and see what they say. Yeah, they good. Yep.
And clear direction.
Yes, lah. I see my profit is there.
Next one. What about you?
I have submitted my project in a...
Yeah. He doesn't want to share out loud.
No,
not
to share, I mean...
But that's
I don't know.
So, because I want to do about something about VR. So, during the holiday, the 1 month holiday, I actually learned how to program a Unity engine. A graphic engine. So, I learned for 1 month. And then, I said, maybe we just can do something about the VR technology. Use the Unity engine. And then, what I want to do is... this is something about phobia. If you are phobia of something, you will like try to avoid, right? But I learned in psychology term also.
You're supposed to face it.
To actually go against your phobia, you have to face it like multiple times until
what,
you say.
What? Can you get directions for her? Especially to you.
Direction.
Yeah. Right? Her fear is getting lost in direction.
I don't forget, I always get lost.
Yeah, I can bend the both of you all together.
Yeah, like fist bump. Oh yeah, she has experienced that. She
in one morning, in like within less than 1 hour.
Yeah. So many different times.
But probably you can do like a virtual reality, because right now for like racing team, right, we keep depending on how fast the car can be done, then only we can practice the car. Maybe you can come up with like a virtual reality that relates to the car that we're building even before the car is done, so then we know how it feels like.
No, if you want to do that, you just finish the model at SolidWorks or something, just give it to me, I just program it.
Yeah, usually the designing is already done, so I can just submit it to you.
Okay, but it takes time lah.
Of course lah. So you have to like, have you come up with your car?
Yeah.
Are those assumptions testable?
I think I have three concerns. One assumption is people won't buy it, they won't buy that product, right? So I don't care because I want to give it for free so that people can just use it for to
face their fear.
And then secondly, my concern is that maybe people don't believe this thing can be some phobia cannot be treated, so they don't care. And then one more thing is VR technology is not widespread yet.
Yes.
That's three of my consumption.
So, what are your target?
Usually people with phobia. And then maybe
everyone has phobia.
Psychologist. Next thing, maybe counselor.
So you need to figure out like, how you're going to run your tests.
Yeah. Right? Because low is afraid of lizard. Maybe you can just...
Okay, oh, lizard. I thought a lot of people are afraid of lizard.
I also got shareholder this 20% also.
Oh, yeah.
I just have to program a lizard moving towards you. but the picture is not real, means it's just like
yeah.
Don't tell me about fake and not
real. I think someone that not afraid of lizard, you're afraid of lizard.
Yeah.
You just wear
yeah,
the Google.
Yeah.
Google start the test and then. No. I mean, you just see lah. But if you sit down, the lizard will come really.
Oh, tell me when you have developed that, because you know who to run the test.
You just want to try it lah.
Huh?
You like to work.
Can I know what
Mushtaq
is fear of?
Me, I'll try it on someone else.
Can I know what
Mushtaq
is fear of?
Mushtaq.
Small dreams.
Small
dreams.
Mushtaq.
Small dreams.
Good. I think I get deleted somewhere.
What about you?
Oh, yeah, go behind.
Okay.
Yeah.
Who? You and?
This one. My leader.
Your leader?
He covered me the idea. This one, I only took 30% of me.
My God.
30% everywhere.
30% of everything. So, what's your project about?
Oh, I'm doing buggy service, but I wanted to change really. Because my customer range is too small. Only limited to this university. So I'm planning to do which have more customer and it's easy for funding. So I'm still thinking the idea.
Still thinking?
I already submit the buggy service after things.
So say if it's somewhat related or if you have changed a little bit based on today's discussion and all that, the first item in your project section is describing your project, so you can describe it again.
You have referred.
Okay. I already submit the previous one, the buggy service.
So are you both brainstorming?
Yeah, basically yes. Yeah, I try to get ideas from other groupers.
What about you? Are you working alone?
Yes, I'm working alone.
Working alone.
I just want to wonder, right? They say that if the things are like overdue, that means we still can do or what?
It's overdue, but you can still submit
it all. Let's say that.
Make sure you submit everything. Because, like, you know, all our assessments carry
One more thing, because I didn't came for like the first 2 weeks.
Sorry?
I didn't came for the first 2 weeks, so I'm a bit lost already. So that means everything here we must submit to the online.
All the activities and stuff. You are supposed to click on it, and then you are supposed to answer it.
And one more thing, I see the breaking down of scheme of work is like, Chris is 10%, all these things, right?
So yeah, this is like on test, and then all these stuffs will be coming from our open learning. So each actually carries some marks and all that, that's why it's important for you.
So that means
if it's overdue, never mind. Just try to submit it.
So that means the brain rewiring means every class we must do the thing, right?
Yes. Know what
is yeah, something you're grateful of for the day.
You get done it for today?
Yeah, done it.
What are you grateful for?
Good environment, entertainment, fresh air, and more thing. I do fiber.
You want to have been thinking about your idea already?
Yeah, for the project, right?
Yeah. Have you thought of it? And then your core assumptions?
Yeah. That means we need to come up with these things, right? Who's the customer? What kind of the challenges are facing?
So those are whatever that you have submitted, you would have submitted in your the lead startup tutorial under item number 2 or item number 3.
Oh.
Alright, there's a list for you to answer and everything. So for today's one, you can use project selection, this one that you can click on. Use that as a guideline for your presentation for next week.
That means the project, you must build the project or just give the idea only.
It depends on what you want to crowdfund for. You know that by the end, this idea will be translated into a crowdfunding campaign, right? So when your crowdfunding campaign is successful and all that, obviously by then, you would have reached our end of semester. So you will be committed to execute the product of your idea. It could be service, it could be product, it could be anything else.
Okay.
Are you clear about what you're
doing?
Miss.
Why are you like jumping?
Miss. Yeah, miss first.
Like chips more. After this, right? So.
Yes, miss.
What do you guys have?
We have solar.
Solar. Alright. Yes. So, what are you doing? What's your project about?
I want to ask you first, miss. Do we have to make the project?
Define make the project.
We have to demonstrate it or just have to make it online just for the crowdfunding, right? Yes.
Just for crowdfunding, but you know that after your crowdfunding is successful, you are committed to execute the plan, right?
Yes,
so it depends on what you do.
Yeah, we are targeting remote villages in Sabah, Sarawak. Because of the terrains, they can't able to transfer electricity to their house.
Okay.
So we are building a solar panel on their house. We'll give them current and at a cheaper rate also.
Will this be doable for you to crowdfund? Because you know by week 6 you have to like put it up and put it up. Because like, I think you see that like, whether it's just hiding or prototype or whatever. Like you're making a program like this.
No, we're just bringing solar panel, introduce solar panel to the remote villages.
So how are you going to introduce solar panel?
We have to...
Are you bringing over the whole solar panel to these villages? Or you're selling the idea or educating them?
Yeah, educating them about how to use it, when to use it, how does it work.
Because some of the remote villages, they don't get electricity much.
Yeah.
So the most cheaper and easiest way to get is solar.
So what's your project about?
It's about
you want to be educating them. What are you doing? What are you going to do? That's something that you need to ask.
What do you suggest we do?
Well, it's your project, so that's something that you really need to do.
So we plan to do about solar. So about these remote villages, so we have to educate them, is it?
No, it's totally up to you. That's why I'm asking, like, whether you're like, bringing the product or you're like crowdfunding for purchasing solar panels or because solar is very diversified, right? I mean, like,
even with Solat itself, they say that they have identified the issue with Sabah, Sarawak, and want to make solar power, economics, and whatnot. What's your perspective on that? And I think about it, because by the end of the day, you want to crowdfund, right? And crowdfund for money, for something, for the project that you want. Mm-hmm. And you want to make sure that this thing is doable, in such that when the crowdfunding can be successful, then you'll be sort of complete that in the 6 to 8 months after.
Can we like crowdfunding just to raise awareness for the people in the...
You want to raise awareness, but you need to make sure that your idea is feasible and the money that you need, where you're going to put it at, what you're going to put it for. So all these
things. Need to look.
Yeah, and then that's why we ask you to perform function, customers, what are the challenges faced by them, right? But, and then you want to be running the test as well, because this week is about discussing, and then you want to run the test, and then by next week you have the results, the findings ready. So by next week when I see you, you are going to present to me, and like, oh, this is actually working, or this is not working. If it's working, then if it's not working, which are the things for
Yes.
Right. So I think you're still in the very starting of the idea and all. You generally know what to do, but you haven't really thought it in depth of what you want to really do. So think about it. Something that is doable within the time. Use the project selection as the guideline for you for your discussion. Alright, let me go to you first. I'm going to come to you and ask you for ideas, yeah? Why are you moving here?
Means I was, because we went there, then they said we cutting queue. Yeah. Then we after them, we call you, they said still cutting queue.
Oh.
We came back to the queue.
I appreciate that you are waiting to share your ideas.
Miss,
I love that kind of attitude.
Enthusiasm.
Yes!
Miss, you got a new idea. The idea is... Yeah,
we discussed it with previous supervisor Dr. Edwin.
Yes.
Said not to do it.
No, not that one. That guy Sam. Tuesday.
Oh.
We told Dr. Edwin because we want to tell him first because he's the one who helped
it out. We don't infringe any copyright.
Yeah. So he hasn't said anything yet. Till then, yeah. And then Miss, we have another idea. For crowdfunding. Because the zip we cannot do, remember? So it's a power generating speed breaker.
Power generating?
Speed breaker. For example, you know the hump, right?
Alright.
Okay, you know those when you go to the parking, parking lots and all that, you have that plastic kind of hump.
Mm-hmm.
So we plan to, for example, the force that you use on the hump, you can collect the energy used, store it.
You can convert the force and change it to something else, lighting a bulb, turning a fan, powering the traffic light, something like that. It just converts the energy.
So you're working on the converter. Is it like a product that you're thinking of?
Is this a prototype?
It's a prototype.
Is it something that you have been working on?
It's an idea. Because some of my friend actually did this. Sort of, he was studying about it. So
they actually collect the energy from all the things,
yeah.
And after that,
that energy, the force, can be used to do something else.
Yeah. For example, light a street light, you know?
So someone has done this.
Someone.
Right? You know of your friend?
Yeah, yes.
It actually works.
It works.
So
I mean, my friend actually just did the prototype. Mm-hmm. He didn't actually do the whole project because it was part of his research. Isn't it? So actually, we have.
What's your friend? I mean,
FYP? Yeah,
FYP.
Yeah.
ME. So, we thought maybe we can use it for the
crowdfunding.
What did you want to crowdfund?
We want to crowdfund, for example, like maybe to build the actual model of it,
try to do it.
So, then it comes back to the three things.
We have already discussed among ourselves and answered the questions.
Answers already? So, have you submitted?
No, not.
You have to redo because we did for ZIP.
Yeah.
So we have to redo it.
So we have to redo it.
But it's okay. I mean, like, because later on when you look at the project selection, right? Take that as a guideline for you to for the next week's presentation also. Because you also want to run on the test to see whether the customers like it. Who are your customers?
The government.
The government.
Yeah, because the government is the one who makes the speed breakers, right? I mean the hubs, right?
So maybe
because it will help in reducing the usage of non-renewable energy sources. Making this one can be used
more greener.
So government is a bit too general. You want to like
construction maybe.
Be more specific on it. Then your core assumptions. And then what have you identified? What core assumptions you're going to use?
Core assumptions are. Core assumptions means why we think that this device or thing might be needed,
sort of like
right?
A preliminary hypothesis.
Okay, so
that you
what,
and then you want to test out see whether it's.
What we came up was with to reduce the consumption of non-renewable energy. Oh, no. Because it is being. Used up,
yeah.
Finishing up renewable energy
is drying off.
So that's one of the reasons. And the second one is what?
Make it more greener. For example, like you use a lot of non-renewable energy, you know, it leads up to pollution and stuff like that, right?
So if let's say like this, right, then you want to make your core assumption to something like your customer would want to have like green energy.
Yeah.
Then our riskiest one we took was to reduce the cost.
The riskiest one?
That's what we took, right?
So you want to test out, have you thought of how you
maybe we're going to do a survey?
Yeah, maybe a survey.
So you want to like target the customer and see whether it's really the government who's supporting you. Or sometimes like when you're running the survey and all that, then you find out, oh, actually it's not the government, actually it's like someone else or whatever. You'll find from based on the test that you run, that you're able to find out something like probably something that you improve on in your project or probably like the customer segment actually gets benefited from other direction.
So Miz, actually the prototype is just the prototype that we plan to do is actually just that how the concept works. We don't have to show that it actually lights up a traffic light. Just show, like for example.
Yeah, it's fine if you want to work out a prototype.
Yeah, the prototype is like for example, like you just have like a dynamo, okay? So you press the energy,
yeah.
And then circulate, and then the light bulb lights. That's it.
But it's good if you really thought about it, really, then you want to like be able to already track the prototype.
Yeah.
Prototype
yeah, yeah. We
when people see prototype, then it seems more credible.
Yeah.
Right. So, what are you going to talk about? Is it like the prototype or the money to actually
build
it?
Yeah.
Build it.
And then you will also like.
Actually, by then, actually, for example, like we actually get the money to build the original one to test whether how much of energy, for example, we can actually gain from this, you know? Because like it's an idea, right? We still have to, in order for us to test the whole idea, we need a lot of resources and money and stuff like that.
So you really need to think about like how much you can get for that. But before that, you're gonna test it out and see whether it's usable or not. If the customer likes it and all, then you the next step will be we will discuss later on for the crowdfunding part. And really that break down the thing. I think if you look at your project selection or whatever also, they ask you to look at the successful crowdfunding platform, see why they are. See the category that's like the closest one related to your project. See why they're successful. Look at their, check out their videos and how they actually tell the story.
Actually, for example, I mean, you go to the website and check it out.
Yeah. And then see what are the stuff that you can use to make it
more successful.
It's doable? Is it doable for you?
The prototype is doable. It's
doable.
It's doable.
It's doable. But they're not sure
about the actual one. Yeah, because it's still a study. See?
Yeah. I mean, like, it's all about. I mean, like, but it would be good if you have come up with a prototype.
Prototype.
So you really like study.
I'm gonna ask about my project.
Oh, perfect.
No, you cannot ask.
Go.
Finish
it.
No.
Are you alone?
With Farah.
With Farah?
Yeah.
Okay.
She tells
you
too.
Like, were you next to
Farah? Farah,
I spoke to Farah earlier.
Oh.
So do you have the similar idea? Are you guys on the same page?
What is the page that she's on?
I want to know what was the one that you wanted to tell me.
Because we haven't decided yet, like, we're like going forward.
That's all today, right?
You're supposed to be discussing it.
Almost four.
Have you discussed it before?
Yeah, we discussed before. We just wanted to discuss it with you.
Let's see whether it's possible.
You know what to do, right? Next week is the presentation. You will
Friday, okay. So the presentation we have to present
based on the guidelines or whatever that you have found out, and then the, your project selection, right? Look at it, see what it is.
It's under the Lean Startup.
Yeah. Have you done your pre-rewarding for the Lean?
Yeah.
What are the 5 things you
prefer? I'm grateful that today is less haze. I'm grateful for my friends, lunch, and tonight there is a show.
What show is that?
Above and Beyond is playing tonight.
Sorry?
You never heard of it? Above and Beyond. In KL Live.
Oh,
and
right.
Today is the last day of the week, Friday.
Okay, you guys are into that. Are you into that?
Sort of.
Four? I mean, only two of you are interested.
No, I think I'm the only one going.
Yeah, he's the only one going. I'm not going.
He's going.
Alright, so what about
the
project?
And
see whether it's aligned to
your product. I think the survey, must it be, for example, you have to do an online survey or...
Up to you really, I leave it to you and
please, other than the survey, what could we do to test it?
Like, reach out to the person physically, ask them whether they are... So it can be a lot of methods of how you do it. You can run like multiple different tests also to collect different data. Look at, think about which one will give you the most accurate result. And usually the most accurate result is when you read it and do it on.
So if we ask somebody, we should ask the person who manufactures, I mean who actually does harm to know that. I mean, speed breaker.
You should ask the target customer. Because by the end of the day, when you think about who to ask, when you're asking someone who will buy your product or will eat or those who will catch for you. So those are the people that you want to. And then you want to be like more specific. So you can't just say that like all.
Is there any rubric for the
Sorry?
Is there any rubric for the presentation?
Well, it depends. Everything is kind of submersive.
I mean how the rubric? I mean do you like
I will layer the rubrics until later, but I would say that this one will be important because like Paris will be important. So you know that marks is like
50
this one
years.
50 marks, right? And like all these 50 marks will come from like
day 1 until day 8 and
we have finished. So, what about?
Actually, my project was about the Syrian funding stuff. I don't know if it's around part of the...
Well, what about?
The Syrian refugees, like around the world.
Yeah.
Because she has an idea and I have this idea, but we haven't agreed on that.
But we want to, like, are you working on it individually?
Sorry?
You want to be working on it individually? Have you signed?
Oh, no. So, maybe. Like, I'm not sure about it yet.
So, what about it?
Actually, I would like to raise funding for the Syrian refugees in Jordan. There is actually an official website where you can, like, support them by donating some money, and the money goes directly to their account. So, there is no an agent or anything like that. So, and they put a limit for the people that need help for. So, that's my idea of the project.
But it's very general. You want to really define it generally. Like, who are your customers? Who will be the one who will be with you and the passion? Right? Because you want to raise money for them. If you want to work on the project, then it's time to think about the customers. What are the challenges?
The challenges is like, people accepting to donate the amount of money that people need. This is the challenges. And I think...
Because you know that nowadays we have so many charities and stuff.
Yeah.
So you need to make sure that if you are going to work on the project, it is standing out because it's different from all the other charities that are going on in Japan. Because like, if your charities, the raising fund from your side is the same as every other organization.
Yeah, that's what I told you. Like, usually the charity goes to an organization, and the organization delivers to the people who need help. But for this one, you only have to donate, and the money goes directly to the the people who need the money. They have their own card, the ATM card. So whenever you donate, it goes to the family that you're donating to.
So you need to establish their credibility.
Okay.
Because like people have been wondering,
how do I hire like 10 or 11 people?
Because they like they made an interview with them.
So what will be the GC?
Is it should be in engineering for Team Grand Challenge? But if it's related to Grand Challenge in global, that can work.
As long as you can align addressing one of them. Because what I noticed is that a lot of you are very scoped into the technical side. Actually, Malaysia is not open to this kind
of thing. Our generation is coming up.
So this is the difference between the my project and the other charity. And actually there is, they made an interview with people in there because this donation is going to go to a Syrian refugee in Jordan. They have the special place there. They made an interview with them, like the procedure when someone donates and how it goes to the families. How often, like, if, and the donation is different from like a family which has one child, or there is only a couple. So,
yeah. Are you feeling strongly about this?
Really strongly.
Really strongly about it, then you have to benefit from the people who are all these things. You just start addressing it. And you know, like,
because now, yeah, that's exactly it. Because now many people want to help these people. You see the picture and you see the videos around the world, but they don't trust the
so, the question now, since you know that a lot of you trust them, so the question is, how can they trust you? So you ask yourself, like, how are you?
And
what makes you stand out from the rest? That could be someone that you ask and raise money.
Because like the there is a website for it, and the website is trusted. And as I told you, they made an interview with people who are living there and
so
say,
you need to really come up with why and then, you know,
so in that
activity, the core assumptions, your project selection.
I didn't do it.
So you didn't start doing it?
Yeah, because still, like, I want to consult
and
with you. Like,
whatever that you have, you need to really, like, come up with that. And then, because by this, you really need to start running the test and all. So you want to be talking to certain specific target customers.
So who's going to be the customer then in this
case? Then you should be really
the only country
you can go is the people who are in so if like some person are talking about all these aspects you want to see
this
because like in some countries, like in Arab countries, this is specific. Most people feel the war because some of them like had some war and then they finish with it, so they can't. They know the feeling of you, when you don't have a house, you don't have food.
Okay.
Start doing
Miss.
I'd like to ask for the value proposition. This one is for like, I'm not really sure about this question.
Value proposition is when you come up with a project. Yep. Alright. So in what way your project will be different? I think the difference or better compared to the rest of the people.
Means like we need to search online about the like similar project for us.
No, not necessarily, because like project is something that you have come up with, right?
Yep.
So it would be something like why this project? Like if like we are like the layman and we don't know anything about the project, we will ask you, how's your project different than the others? What are the better points or what are the better or benefits that you bring this project? How is it different?
So it's like we need to like persuade to our funder about the ideas.
So value proposition is something that you come up with, it's like some sort of like a mission statement, but then again it actually addresses how your project is
different from the others.
Or how is it better than the others.
Oh,
so
okay.
Like for example, like if you say like failures and all that, you will just say like to provide higher education. Hello, I mean like it's not just failures who does that. Other universities are doing that as well. So what stands out from different, like make it different from the others?
So
ours is like to educate the youth to become like someone of a leader.
For us is like we want to like make a, let's say a speech to the like the young generation. But then we need to like,
what speech are you doing?
Yours like about the what is engineering, like when you're inside the engineering field, what will you do and like what is your future, like you're interested in which kind
of
things.
So if you're really interested in making a speech related to engineering, then you will need to come up with a value proposition. How is your speech going to be different from the others? How is it different? How is it better? Because like we have multiple speeches, a lot of speeches by everyone and all that. So your value proposition will be the one that stands you up to the rest of the people wondering the same thing. Is it clearer now?
Yep.
So are you, so what are your core assumptions? How are you going to assess up your assumptions?
Like, first core assumption is like the people, like let's say the younger generation is not interested. So maybe we will do like a paper survey or online survey to them. So it's like depending.
So then is, who are your customers? You want to really be like?
Yep, we are like trying to get for the like international school student, which is like either Taylor or.
So if you're talking about international school, it means that you want to run the test with this international school.
Yep.
Alright, so everyone's clear about what to do.
Yep.
Because like by next week, we need to have come up with the findings of the result and you need to do a presentation on what you have found out, whether your project is strong enough to stay, or you're in a position.
So we need to do it as a PowerPoint as well.
Up to you. If you can do a PowerPoint, you can do anything. We need it to be up to you.
Okay.
But I would say that this is actually carries quite a bit of work.
Okay, our project is basically producing a video like about 30 to 40 minutes to give awareness about CDIO process and grand challenge awareness. So,
does any of you possess videography skills or whatever?
I had ever made a 1 hour video before. In a unprofessional way, but yeah, it can be done. So if we can't find the money, which about 2,000 like that, maybe you can hire some
professional. More professional.
So your aim is to come up with
a video with the host by Dr. Mustard. We provide more detail and more explanation about it.
The person who's delivering this is professional.
Yeah, I think
have you spoken to him?
Haven't yet, because we need to speak to you first and approve of our project. So,
well, if you want to run the project or whatever, then you want to have that thing, and then the important person is the one.
Yeah, but haven't decided yet, so need to decide with you first. Then,
so, who are your target customers?
Okay,
who's going to view this video?
Okay, our target customer is. So, in research, we noticed that Taylor University adapt CDIO process. Other universities adapt their own process of engineer thinking or designing a product. So we want to help the university. Okay, our main target of customer first is university. Second is those inventors.
University, just to generate.
university, so lecturer or business maybe master.
Who implements EI?
What
field, what program, or whatever?
Engineer.
So you want to be very specific.
Okay. Then second customer is like the inventor. They have their own way to implement their product in their own process. So maybe we do this video to show them about CDI or process to make them more easier, or like student who study in a university engineer field where they need to apply this CDI or process, and maybe this one give them a clearer picture about the steps and the grand challenges.
But you know that now we are running classes on home and all that, basically on online course and everything.
Yeah,
so, so what makes it stand out more compared to the other courses that are already there? Do you want to do something on CDI? Have you guys checked out the CDI website itself? We need to check it out and see whether there's really something to do with that. Then if you really want to do and carry on with it, you have to really distinguish yourself. Compared to the others or whatever you want to do. You're going to make the CDI. Okay. You're asking them, like, have they check out the CDI website itself? Because this company, you see, have to do yourself. And they wanted proper stuff to make. So I was like, you need to find out to see whether
can right? Because we're paying him, by the way, and promoting his book also.
His book.
And he's the one who wrote the CDI.
You want to make sure that this project actually like is different compared to whatever other
you
because when you do something on CDIO, first of all the first thing that you should actually check is the CDIO website itself. See what's already there. And see whether your video is really gonna make a difference or not. Or if it's just gonna be the same as whatever is there on the site. If it's the same, then it's just gonna be another.
So make it special.
You want to make it like make
we invite Mustak. It's very special.
Yeah.
He the one wrote the book. He the one.
You want to, so what I mean is that you need to be as specific as possible.
Sure, sure. Yeah, sure. No problem.
So that's why our video is like CDIO by Mustak.
Think like engineer.
Okay. Okay. Maybe we change
that. Run the test.
Okay, sure.
Alright. You need to be as specific as possible. Because like, right now what I see is that you are also not exactly sure if this is doable or right? So I want you to have like, you know, by next week you know that, well, this is working. Or well, this is not working. I'm going to like change my direction a little bit. Probably something related to CIO, but not just CIO video. But you are looking for funding for the video production, is it? So you want to like really convince us of how your video or your project is different or carries more value.
No problem.
Alright, you're confident with it?
Yes. You must know everything is settled.
You want to find, you want to know your findings about it by next week. Alright, you know that you have to do a presentation. Right?
Yeah.
Yeah, your findings, look at your project selection.
When is the presentation? Next week? Friday?
So you guys are into that? Are you the only one who's into this or?
No, it's just a game. Pass the time.
In the class?
No.
So is it still the same as what you have?
No, we got a different idea. We actually posted it onto the page.
Alright, so generally what it's about, what's your core assumption and how you consider it?
It's about parking.
Parking?
Yes.
Alright, what about parking?
So sometimes, you
what's
know...
What's your... Oh, you're sitting so far.
I've already discussed the idea already.
Alright,
so... So anyways, the idea is to have... You know how people have trouble looking for parking sometimes? Like, they're not sure if there's parking inside that row or not because they can't see.
Yeah.
So we'll have a flag to indicate that there's parking in the row.
Mm-hmm.
So to do that, people will have to take a flag. I mean, sorry, the flag will be there. If there's parking, it will be raised. And if there's no parking, it will be lowered. Yeah.
And it's like when the car park goes, the car goes through and all that, the thing is like just in the middle like that and everything.
No. Because the parking in Zone H specifically is free, you know, it's not fixed, right? So what we have is, let's say this is a row of cars. We have one flag, which will be raised or lowered based on if there's parking inside the row. So what we expect our users to do is to raise the flag when they park. Just raise the flag. Sorry, when they park, they lower the flag, and when they leave, before they leave, just put on the flag.
So where will be the?
Every row there will be one pole.
So like every parking space, you will see like a pole.
No,
there.
Every row, one row of parking will have one flag. It's only for dealers. The zone.
So
case,
as in,
for
if
now,
everything
yeah.
is full, then no flag.
Yeah, when there's parking, flag. So basically, at the start of.
So it has to be the last person who parks the car that actually.
Yeah, yeah. Just raise up the flag. Like, it's gonna be there. It's already there, prepared for you. Just up.
So your core assumption.
Understanding what the flag means.
Alright, and then you also want to make sure that.
There are a few. Yeah, the willingness of the users to raise the flag.
So which one are you gonna test out? Are you gonna test out like?
It'll be simultaneous.
So how?
Our plan is to have posters. Not the area before you walk to the parking. There's a loading bay.
So you're targeting only on zone feature?
Yeah. For now we're targeting only on zone feature. Because that's the only place where people actually have problems. Yeah, have problems looking for the parking because they can't really see if let's say there's a car there.
One thing that is somewhat similar to something related to parking for last semester, they actually wanted to do an umbrella project for like the sun and everything.
So pass the umbrella.
Yeah, something like that. Another one is an app for car park and stuff.
Apps or car park don't work for open areas yeah. because there's no sensors.
So like for you now and all that, what you can do is to check out the company website, see whatever that you've seen in previously. You can identify properly what are the areas of
the beneficial part about this project is that it's cheap. Because all you need is a flag and hope.
So now you are very clear about what to do and all your step is to run the
test. We will run the test next week on Wednesday.
And you know that by Friday you should have had
it. Yeah, basically we'll run the test on Wednesday. Then after that we'll put on an online survey the next day. The day after
so
or during
if,
the night.
If you see this potentially successful and whatever,
it will be crowdfunding for the materials to build this thing up.
So you want to give like some sort of like a stature?
Yeah. It won't be a profitable project, more of a problem solving
project. Are you guys still with the P and all that, not trying at all to eliminate it?
Challenge solving.
Challenge solving, yes.
You don't seem to believe it when you mention
imagination.
Yeah, anyways, yeah.
So run the test, see what happens and all that, see if your friend will be nice enough to want to make the time and all that.
It's okay, the crowdfunding will only cost around 100 or so for now. If you want to make a better system, then the cost will go up, so we'll go with a minimum and we'll increase to a better system if the amount that is donated is higher than the one amount that we set. Like a certain limit we will go for this, certain limit we'll go for better and certain limit we'll go. Is that okay?
Yeah, you wanna make sure so run the test, see what happens and all that. Alright.
Alright.
Want something that is doable and neither do we want to set anything that is like too minimum or too low that is too easily successful. But at the same time, we do not want to be like, you know, like some of your friends last time, they actually asked for 35,000 or whatever. But not that it's not doable, it's doable, but of course, it actually has to like, translate into the effort of
it. It takes time.
Yeah, and so we want to like have a proper follow up.
And since you only have one semester, yeah.
Why are you smiling? I'm like, oh, okay, one semester. Yeah, you want to make sure that it's within
yeah.
our idea. And we wanted to ask about the legitimacy of this
okay.
idea.
Okay.
Very hard word.
Yeah.
Okay.
I already, like, my heart is really pumping upon doing that.
Oh,
what?
Okay.
Have you spoken to it? Yes, I already spoke to her.
Why are you there?
And also, I think I also want to go talk to Mushtaq later, just to ask his advice also. So this is our idea. We are going to, we're doing personalized learning. So we're going to put up a website where we can share the university sources. For example, Taylor's University, Monash, Segi, Nkakwin, whatever other universities there are in Malaysia, all their sources for mechanical engineering, specifically mechanical engineering, their tutorials, their lectures, if they want to, but I don't think they'll share tests. But all their sources that we can share will be shared in one website where all students in Malaysia, and actually anyone can use it, but it will only be Malaysian universities, have access to it. Now this is our main feature, which we are going to try and promote it based on that. Aside from that, we also have an online sources, free sources, references to those free websites. For example, when he joined, he didn't know about Khan Academy, for example. But this website will eliminate eliminate the possibility of a student not knowing of such a very useful source. You know, you can actually teach yourself at Khan Academy. And there are so many other websites. Help me pass math one.
She
taught us math before.
Ah,
math. Yeah.
You recall seeing him in class? Oh, okay.
Yeah, so it helped us pass math one, and it's very useful. And there are other also websites that I'm sure I don't even know of, so we're going to do the research and we're going to look for it. And we're going to post it for all the students to know about it, so they can, you know, have that opportunity. Something like that, for all students to some one stop to go to get all their sources. But this is specifically only for Malaysia. I'm not trying to make it global, at least not at this point.
Yeah.
Make it so small. In fact, we're making only for Malaysia and only for one course, mechanical engineering. And we're going to try and focus on only the first semesters, which, semester one, semester two, semester three, that's it. First year students, to make it manageable. And some gadgets, small gadgets, to make it look more interesting, maybe like a GPA, calculator, those small gadgets you can find in any other website. And then one of our good features is also the online forums. Students can upload their questions that maybe they get it from a very different source and they can discuss it. Yeah. It sounds... True.
So are you guys developing this website or?
Now that's the thing, we're crowdfunding for some, we're going to come up with the idea, but we don't have the technical expertise to do this.
You can find someone to do
it. And that's the crowdfunding for.
Make it alive.
We bring it to life, and then to manage it is not really, it's not going to cost much. I think after that, to sustain the website, it's just going to be maybe through donations or crowdfunding, or if we have to come to it, we put ads. But there's not much. It's only the cost of putting the website up there, which is very low, can be sustained by ads alone. Another one of our features is the homepage is going to have all the newsfeed of engineering events, seminars, and notices that are related to students that they can benefit from. Like if there was a seminar, if there was an event, if there was, for example, Taylor's University is having their engineering fair. Taylor's engineering fair is open to everyone. Anyone can come, but no other universities come because it's not promoted. So this is a platform for universities to promote their events. SEGI can have their engineering fair, Taylor students, other students can go there. So it's not only for Taylor students, it's for all students of engineering. So something like that. Pretty much. So
you will have to convince the other universities to take
That's the challenge. That's the main challenge.
And that's why. How are you going to test this?
Number one, First, I wanted to ask you if it sounded even realistic.
Just now you're like,
exactly.
Like,
that's
the idea.
You're going to ask you that.
Yeah.
It's interesting and all that, but then again, it definitely takes a lot of work because it involves so many people.
It is true. That's the only problem.
To find out whether you can change.
Yeah. So, the tutorial session today is all about, and at least you have like an idea of what you want to put in there. And you know the core assumption that we see is part of.
So that's why we want to talk to. I'm just gonna set an appointment with Mushtaq, and since he's the dean, I'm guessing he would know how to approach other deans from other universities, or better yet, if he has contacts that I can just go straight to them.
So you are going to test out this assumption when?
No, this is the problem. Next week,
Friday, we want to know something.
Yeah, and then we have three tests, and we have this. I have to talk to universities, and so, oh man, and then also someone else. Oh my god, I don't know.
What are the three tests?
What do we have?
I have something to do.
But you don't have a
test.
I have introduction to electronics. I have theory of machines. I have
answers. Hello. In case you haven't found out, you can ready.
Postpone. Oh, thank God, thank you.
Have you checked times?
Actually, you know what? I did check times yesterday, and for some reason, for some reason, when I looked at the, times under introduction to electronics, all the lecture notes have disappeared.
Was it underneath or was it?
I'm not really sure, but there was two before. And now there's only one.
I think supposedly it's really updated, so...
Okay. I was panicking. I was like, what am I going to study?
So, since then, there's already been postponed, but you're going to have next week's class. I think it's going to be 40% and then it's going to be next week's class.
So, that's much better. So, then I only have two tests.
Alright, see, then that's when you actually can get running and running. That's the whole main point. Since you mentioned introduction to DD.
Oh, man.
Okay.
Yeah.
How could you forget? I think I saw you in the class the other day.
Yes, I was.
Didn't you forget that I was there?
True. It's not that, but yeah. Yeah, so he sees you like 3 times a week. No, he doesn't do electronics, never mind. So that's pretty much, we want to talk to Mushtaq. We want to see how we're going to approach the deans, and also if it is even possible, because I don't know, maybe there's something beyond our knowledge, maybe there's some politics between universities that they don't want to share. These are all possibilities. These are core assumptions.
We
don't know what's going on.
Because sometimes there are also like institutions that are very
reserved with their resources.
Yeah,
so
want to really safekeeping.
Exactly. So we need to see that. We need to see the universities that are willing. So core assumptions, I guess, would be if they're open, the main one would be if universities are open to share their resources with us.
But another good thing about testing it out is that should this, let's say, just in case that this actually doesn't work out because of the resources, probably by running the test, you should have found out something else that actually can be used.
There's always, I was talking to Sanjay and he also suggested something. I actually forgot what he suggested, but it did click in my head. It did click in my head. So I think another important factor is seeing what people think about this and what they can suggest. What can be eliminated? Because, for example, this gadget thing is not really necessary, but I think it's a cool feature. But if people think that it's going to make the website look funny or lame or...
And other
small things. Yeah. Just some minor gadgets.
Not necessarily GPA calculator, maybe something else.
Yeah. So it can be anything. Curve calculator, but I don't think Malaysia uses a curve system. Whatever else. Anything. So we just try to come up with whatever gadgets. Maybe we can get inspired by other websites. And we'll see.
You use Khan Academy for resources and stuff. So
that's one of them.
And then definitely you have seen like some stuff that you really like because like you want to get the mission, right? So you know what you have used and
Exactly. So this is basically the simple thing. As I said, we're going to make it only for one year, the first year students for mechanical engineering to make it manageable. Plus, I think at this stage, students are more open to using such a feature if it was introduced to them. Because if they introduced this to me at my stage right now, I wouldn't bother to use it because I'm used to my old ways of studying.
What are your old ways?
You know, tutorial notes, ask friends for help, stuff like that.
The second one.
Khan Academy. Basically, new students are more open to try new things as to old students.
Really?
Yeah, I think it's a common trend. Everyone will stick to their own. More or less.
Yeah.
So that's pretty much it.
So you would have known by now how you can test on this form function, right? And since you only have two tests, so it actually gives you a full time to find out.
I really hope I can book at least three universities next week and talk to all of them somehow. I don't know how.
Yeah, go find out and all
that. Yeah, and I failed to meet Mustafa now. Because he was like, now? Or Monday?
Can you see me? I mean, like, see
now cannot. So it was not possible to meet him today, which is a disadvantage, but we'll have to make it up on Monday.
Yeah, I think you can meet him.
But Monday also, I'm not sure if I can, so I have to email his assistants. Kenji is going to go and talk to him.
Sure.
So,
you guys can get
it. So we have to plan around it, around the test, around the game, figure it out.
It's interesting, but test it out and see what happens.
So what do you think about the idea?
I like the idea, but of course it actually involves a lot
of I think...
Okay.
What hour?
The thing is, it's actually not that much of work. The hardest part will be just convincing the universities.
Yeah, just to get
after that,
yes.
After that is just somehow promoting it so we get the crowd funds. And if we do get the funds, we don't do any work. We're just going to hire someone to do it.
No, but at least you're clear about the direction of what you want to do and whatever expertise that you lack of, you
can. Exactly. Because we don't have any expertise designing, so we're just going to give a rough sketch, rely on his expertise. I actually know someone who can do it. Get it.
Leroy. So now you know what to do, right? Test it out. Talk to whoever this is. Test it out. And by Friday, we'll see a presentation from you. Talk about your findings and whether this stays as what it is or whether it has changed a little bit.
So can I just to ask for the test, for example, do we ask people what do they think about this service?
So you want to be as specific as you can be, right?
So do we present this service to them?
You want to come up with a question that really gets to the point of whether these people are really using it or not. You know, like what Cal said the other day, like if you did hear the team, everyone would say that, like, yeah, maybe we can use it, but you like, have to be more specific. Like, you go on a tomorrow itself. Mm. So it actually makes a difference when you specify or the way you come your question. So questions would be quite important also. Because when you come to the correct one, so that you can get the desired outcome of what you want.
So I guess I will test it with first year college students.
Start thinking about the questions that you
want.
It's totally up to you. I mean, the choice is yours. How you want to test, as long as what you have gone on.
True. Right? So I think that's pretty much it. This is a whole research and our idea. Brainstorms.
Good. Actually, I always like to
organize this.
Yeah, that's good.
It's minus. I understand.
I like it. Good luck to you all then.
Okay, thank you.
Alright.